everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that what are comments in our HTML. In our today's session, we will be starting our complete journey on web scrapping. So today onwards, we will start scrapping the data from a website. So first of all, to scrap the data, we will be talking about an amazing and a powerful function in our beautiful soup, that is the find function. So with the help of find function, we will be scrapping the data. So I'll teach you how this find function works. Let's first understand how this basically works in a program. So if I go back to the same website that we were working on before, and if I, let's say, look for computers, in computers we go for, let's say, tablets here. Okay, and with the help of this find function, we will be fetching the data from here. For example, if I talk about this first box over here, this first box says the div, and inside this div, I'll just open it. And we have many more things. Let's just open it more. And you can see the pull right. There is something called as H4, class is pull right price. And inside this, the price is written. Similarly, if you want to talk about the description, the next thing over here is the description here. Correct. So if you want to obtain, if you want to fetch this data in your Python, all you need to do is use the find function. Now, how to use this find function is very simple. First of all, let's import requests. Also from BS4, we will import BeautifulSoup. Let's pass the URL. For URL, let's go back to our website, copy the URL from here, come back to our program. URL is equals to, inside our double quotes, we will be passing the URL. Once we have passed the URL here, we will be writing r is equals to requests dot get URL and print r. As soon as we run it, this will be our output, that response is 200, but we do not have to print it here. What we need to get is the HTML of this page. For that, we will be writing the same steps that we have been writing since class 4 or 5-ish. So we will be writing beautiful soup. In this, we will be passing r dot text, comma, in the double quotes, lxml. And lastly, now what do we need to get over here is that we are searching for a tag here, right? That we are searching for some H4 tag, and which has class pull right price. Okay. Suppose as of now, if I only talk about div tag, or if I talk about, let's say, a header or something. So if I write print soup dot find, let's pass div tag. So everything inside the div tag, we'll get everything that is there inside our div tag, right? The first div tag here. Now to get the price over here, all you need to do is print soup dot find. Now here you need to pass two parameters. First is your tag. So here we will be passing H4 tag colon. Now at comma. Now at times something like this may happen, that there are same tags but different classes are assigned to them. So in that case, we need to provide the class as well over here. So here for class, we will be creating a dictionary and we will write it inside the double quotation class. And let's go back to our page. And here, as you can see, it says pull right price. That means class is equals to pull right price. And let's just copy it. And let's put a colon here, just like how we write it in a dictionary in the format of a key value pair. Similarly, we have to write it here. Lastly, let's print. We are actually already printing it, so we do not have to write the print statement. We can just directly run it. And as soon as we run it, it gives me 69.99. And if you want to obtain this string from here, all you need to do is put it inside a variable. So this is for price. So price is equals to this. And from here, we will be writing print price dot string. And as soon as we run it, we will be getting $69.99. Similarly, if you want to get the description from here, all you need to do is go to this navigation bar, go for the description. So description is in P tag and the class is description. Let's copy the class from here. Let's go back to our code. And here we will be writing it for description. So DESC, I'll be writing DESC is equals to soup dot find. We'll be giving P tag, comma, class, colon, description. And there is some mistake, so I forgot the braces here. And let's print it as well by writing print dot string, and if I run it, the output would look like this. So this is how you can grab the description. And if you want to know the other method by which we can obtain the class, is we can simply write DESC, or we can simply print soup dot find, and again I'll pass this p tag comma underscore class is equals to. See, one way of writing class is you can put it inside a dictionary, and the other way over here is write underscore class, and then here inside the string you can pass description, and here also you can write dot, and here if you run it you will get none. Why we are getting none is because soup dot find p tag comma underscore class is equals to this. Let me just put it inside something. So a is equals to, and let's print a now. And it's throwing me none over here because I have made a slight mistake. It's not underscore class, but it is class underscore basically. So class underscore, and if you run it, you'll get the data like this. And again, if you want to obtain the string, then put it inside a variable by writing a is equals to this, and then you can print a. And as soon as we run it, okay, we have to write a dot string to get this string. So again, as soon as we run it, we'll be getting 7 screen Android. So this is how you can obtain the strings from here. So if you want to obtain any data from inside of a tag, you can use a find function. But find function over here is only limited to the first div tag that it will find, or first h4 tag that it will find, or first p tag that it will find. Why? Because suppose if I go back over here, let's say I want to obtain it for the Acer icon here. I want to obtain its price. Okay. So if I go over here, here also you'll see it has H4, the same class is there, pull right price. So if I use the same trick here, it won't work because it will only go for the first one. So the first H4 tag, for the first P tag, and for the first div tag. So everything it will find first, it will only get us that data. For finding all the data, for fetching all the data, we have another powerful function in BeautifulSoup. So that we will be learning in our next session. So I hope guys that as of now you have no doubts in the questions and everything that we have covered. In our next session, we are going to talk about another powerful function in our BeautifulSoup, that is find all. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.